Hi, welcome to In a Pickle Knitting and another episode of Some Bunny Loves You. My name is Donna. I'm coming to you from Manassas, Virginia in the U.S. Today is Friday, April 3rd, 2020. Today I have for you another craft that's bunny related and another bunny related children's literature book. So let's get started. To begin, I today have a bunny for you. That is made from this book, Making Luna Lapin. It is written by Sarah Peel, and here she is. And Luna comes also with patterns for a large number of items for her wardrobe and even a little stuffed chair. So she's made from felt, and when I originally purchased this book a year and a half, two years ago, I assumed by looking at it that it was a machine sewn doll, but it is in fact very little machine sewing, just the ears if I recall correctly, and the rest is hand stitching. So I read through the book after I got it and thought, not sure I really felt at the time like doing all that hand sewing. I love to sew primarily on the machine. I've done cross stitch and embroidery and smocking. And all of those things have, not the embroidery, but the smocking and the cross stitch, have a guide for you. And that helps me so much. It's like knitting and crochet. There's a place where everything's supposed to be. But embroidery's not. It's like you're making this little stitch, but where that needle pokes through is up to you. And I struggle with that. So I put the book aside and never made it. So I decided I would make this. And the hand stitching did not take that long. It's just, I'm never happy with imperfection, and my stitches are definitely not perfection, but I've decided I quite like it and I'm perfectly happy with the results, though they are far from perfect. So Luna, before I scare you or surprise you with this, she doesn't have any clothes yet. I only finished her today. So this is a naked bunny, but I think you'll be okay with it. Here she is, as I said, made from felt. I'll hold her back here. She has a little body that would sit, so you could sit her in something like this and still have the legs dangle. When creating her, the ears have a fabric inside of them, and it was very undecided about what fabric to use. And the bottom of the feet have the matching fabric. The rest is made out of felt. So you will make the ears using the sewing machine, and then there's a way that you put them on the head, you create the head. Then you create the legs. You sew the feet to the legs and do your stitching and stuffing. Then the body, and you attach the legs to the body, and finally the arms. And the arms are then sewn on to the side of the body, and they have an additional reinforcement of a button, and you sew through all three layers here. The eyes are buttons, and I used a metal button. I'm not sure if I'm sold on it, if I've decided if they're too large, or did I put them maybe a little too close to the nose? The nose is stitched on with embroidery floss. I'm not getting you good light there. And I'll maybe over here a little better. Nope. Well, it is embroidery floss. I didn't bring the little floss up with me, so I'm not sure what color I used. So she needs a dress. There are also patterns in the book for male clothing. There's a vest and a pair of jeans. So when you get the book, it has pattern pieces in the back for all of the outfits and the bunny, and you copy them and then use those as your pattern pieces. I want to show you the dress. I think I'm going to make is what they call the polka dot dress. I don't have a polka dot fabric. I won't probably make it as a polka dot dress, but this is the dress I'm thinking of making. The pattern here, I used a gray felt. They used a lighter brown felt, which is the color of the bunnies that live in our yard, the brown, but I had gray felt. So there's her little polka dot dress. It has a little Peter Pan collar. It's long sleeve. Rickrack is sewn on the little pocket there. So I thought that might be a dress I'd make, and you see her sitting on her little chair. Isn't that adorable. I would love to make the chair. Don't know that I will, but I would love to make it, and she'd look so sweet sitting on that. So this is a hand-sewn, for the most part, felt bunny, and stuffed, of course, with the polyfiber fill. Though I think some of those heavy beans in the, or beads or beans in the bottom part here might be a good idea. Had I thought of it at the time, I would have done that. So that is our craft for the day. And I'm happy that I finally got around to actually doing this little segment. Pushed me into doing it. I'm really happy that I did. I can't wait to make her some little clothes. So then we have our children's literature book that has a bunny related content. And today I'm choosing to do Too Many Bunnies, formerly titled Too Many Hopkins, which are the name is the name of this bunny family. And this book was written by Tommy DePala, who very sadly passed away this week. And he is one of my favorite authors for children. I love his illustrations and I love so many of his books. So I was very sad to hear of his passing, and the world has lost a wonderful writer for children. So this book about Too Many Bunnies is a family that has quintuplets, triplets, twins, and one child who was born all by himself. He must feel pretty left out. And mom and dad bunny always have the best garden, and they live at the cutest little name. I don't remember. What's the name of their farm? Fiddle-dee-dee Farms. They always have the most finest and most beautiful vegetable and flower gardens in all of Fiddle-dee-dee Farms. And so today they have to go off to the farmer's market or the seed store to get some carrot seeds, and they leave the children with the job of planting the radishes. So each group of children, the quintuplets are to, I forget what they were going to do. Let's see, they're going to dig. And then the quadruplets are going to rake. And the triplets are going to make rows. The twins are going to plant the seeds. And finally, Petey, the single birth, is going to do the watering. Well, when mom and dad leaves, it becomes a free-for-all because no one wants to wait their turn or do anything in any particular order. They're trying to do it all at once. Well, mom and dad come home, and dad's like, Too Many Hopkins, which is the original name of this book. But mom says, now, let's start all over again. It's not that there's too many Hopkins. So she sits them down and starts them off. All right, the quintuplets do their digging, etc. So in the end, you see there are not too many Hopkins. You're right, said Daddy Hopkins. There are not too many Hopkins when they're not all at the same place at the same time, which is of course true for everything. And it has a very hoppy ending. So that's our literature book for today. I wanted to make a short little comment here. Yesterday was, well, my short comments are never short, sorry. I'll just make a comment, turn it off now if you don't want to hear. Yesterday, I had my grandson do the podcast because I realized I had these really short little board books and such that could probably all be done at once. So I thought I'll just do those all at once. And then he'd been doing a couple of crafts. We do a craft every day with a book, but we'd done two little bunny crafts. So I thought, hey, why don't I just try this? So we did that. Now, it's posted as episode 11, and I don't know how it's happening, but I turned it on, and it's not allowing comments. So I went in and changed some things, because on YouTube now, you must state, is your video made for children, or is it not made for children? Mine are not. They're made for you. However, I feel like there's nothing inappropriate that for children, if you were watching and you had any young people about, I don't use any bad language, and I think all of my content is appropriate for all audiences, but I don't make it for them. It's not geared to their entertainment or information, nor was that particular episode yesterday. That was more just something I thought that I would do, and it was intended for my audience who would perhaps some of you would appreciate it or enjoy it. Well, somehow YouTube immediately marked it as, they didn't change the marking, but they put no comments. So I looked at that, why are there no comments? And it said one reason might be because it's for children, but I double checked. I went back actually twice to check. No, I've marked it was not made for children. And so I don't know why. So I went in and I changed a setting and it went back to comments, and then it did it again. And I thought, I don't know why, but I'm not gonna, you know, just keep messing with it like that. So if you made a comment, I might have seen it. I saw three or four. But now maybe if I did it on my computer, I could see the comments, but I can't see anything on my iPad either. I rarely go into the computer except for creating the YouTube videos. I will use the computer. So maybe I can check on that, but I'm sorry about that. I don't know what to do about it, and I'm hoping it doesn't happen again today. We shall see. If it says no comments, it's not my fault. It's not the way I was trying to set anything up, but somehow that got in there. If you wanted to make a comment about that, feel free to do it on this video if you really wanted me to know, or to send me an email at my inapickleknitting@gmail.com account. So that was the first thing I wanted to say. And the second thing was, I did miss a day with you, and I'm sorry for that. I did not intend to miss a day at that time. I said I couldn't guarantee these days, but that was actually a perfect day because my daughter kept my grandson at home that day, because they are working from home, and it's hard for them to work at home with him because he's really loud and he's really busy. But she just felt like, you know, they are home, so one day a week she's keeping him home on Wednesdays. So that was a perfect day for me to have gotten a podcast done. I actually had this little Luna girl to be sewing on, but there was no way I could do anything close up. I have Sjogren's, I've mentioned it before. It's dryness in a variety of areas, but particularly my eyes, that's the place it hits most. And I just about could not keep my right eye open most of the day to focus on anything. It was so painful and burning. And I am so fortunate with my health care, as I've mentioned. We have Kaiser. I emailed my doctor about 11. I thought, this isn't going away. I just kept, you know, drops, 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 different drops, lay down, rest your eyes, hot compress, cold compress, try and do everything to try and make it go away because it was so painful. So she called me back and through a discussion determined that she actually felt like I had some sort of inflammation along with the Sjogren's, just an exacerbation of what normally goes on. So she called in a prescription for me, and they did curbside service. So you literally, they called you back, you made your payment, drove up, they brought it out to the car. So very minimal contact. And we were able to just drive there and drive back home. And I was able to get the drops in that evening. It's four times a day. Not that you care, sorry. But I was able to get one in that evening around dinner time. And then when I went to bed, which was early because it just had been a miserable day and I still couldn't do anything, I did another set of drops and I woke up Thursday. And I'm just so impressed with people, how smart they are, scientists and doctors, to come up with medications that work. It worked like that. I will take it for a week, and I am noticing a little bit of it coming right now, but I still have that bedtime dosage today. But the steroids really must have done something with the inflammation. She absolutely must be right, because my eyes yesterday have not felt that good in at least 10 years. So I'm so grateful for that. But that's why I wasn't with you. I couldn't really work on anything. I couldn't get this done, and I wanted to get this done. Just in my mind, I had my plan. It was going to be this project. I don't know if I'll be with you tomorrow or not. I should be because it is the weekend. However, I know I have one little tiny project, but it's real. Well, it probably couldn't be more simple than the Boo Boo Buddies, right? But anyway, I'm blathering on. I may be with you tomorrow, and I hope to get done with something by Sunday for sure that I can share with you. So thanks so much again for stopping by and joining me, and I hope you didn't think that was too silly to have my little grandson do all of the podcast yesterday, but he said he loved seeing it on television, my daughter said, and he thinks he's a star. So of course we do too. I hope you have a great evening, and I will hopefully be back with you tomorrow. Bye-bye.